Hi, my name is Sanjay, and in this session, I'm going to talk about the role of a programmer. A few weeks back, we asked learners what career choice came into mind when the term IT industry is mentioned. Almost everyone came up with the term programmer. Now, for those who think this is a male-dominated role, here's another statistic. Ada Lovelace, daughter of the famous poet Lord Byron, is considered to be the world's first programmer. A programming language called Ada is also named in her honor. Programmers are found not just in the IT industry, but in almost every field. Cars, airplanes, ships, satellites, computers, cell phones, and many other devices that you see have programs built into them. Finance companies use programmers to build financial models. In fact, the weather predictions that you see on TV are also a result of programs written by people in the field of climate science and image processing. Thus, the first thing for you to keep in mind, programming is done in many fields today and not just IT. Now let's see what a programmer actually does. A programmer, developer, or coder is a person who writes computer programs or code. And programs are a set of precise logical instructions given to a computer. And these instructions are provided via a programming language. And just as we use several languages to communicate with one another, there are several programming languages a programmer can use to communicate with machines and computers. And different programming languages are suited for different types of tasks. We mentioned computer programs, but the term you will hear more commonly is computer software. So what exactly is computer software? Computer software is a broader term used to refer to many computer programs that work together to provide a solution to a problem. Usually, it is not possible for a single person to write the whole computer software. That's why most companies have teams of computer programmers. I will assume that you're a student and are thinking of the necessary qualities to become a software programmer. Let's continue by listing some of them. If you wish to be a good programmer, the key is to get interested in programming. Programming should be fun. Now, a computer itself is dumb and will not understand what to do if you make one single mistake in your program. It has no brain. So the fun part is providing logical and correct instructions to the computer through your program. Then the computer will become happy and will execute your program. Once you begin enjoying this logical process, you may find yourself automatically willing to work more and more. Programming is also a vast field. Not only are there many programming languages, but each language may have unique features. If you are a student, it makes sense to work on programming projects with other programmers. On some projects, you can turn out to be a very good programmer, and on some, not so good. When you are not so good, you learn from others who did better. You should learn at least one computer language very well, and you should know more than one computer language. From an educational point of view, there are many choices, ranging from two-year technical programs to four-year degree programs in a field such as computer science, mathematics, or information systems. You will also find many certification programs available. I would like to add that given the shortage of candidates in this field, it is common for companies to hire students from relevant non-programming backgrounds and train them to become programmers. Now let us move into the future and see you as a programmer. What are some of the joys of the craft? Having spoken to a few programmers, the first point that usually came up was, programming is fun. There is a great joy in seeing your program do something useful. When the result is what you want, you feel great. When it is not, it can be challenging to know what went wrong. Some programmers work with powerful machines handling very large volumes of data, which they find exciting. Programmers are also generally well paid. Many programmers also find their work environment very convenient. As a programmer, you are mostly indoors, close to other developers, powerful computers, and lots of free coffee. Lastly, this is a continuously evolving field, and in many ways, it offers us a glimpse of the future. With computer programming, many aspects of our lives have gotten easier, quicker, safer, and much more interesting. Now let us look at the other side of the coin. Software programming can be a high-pressure job. You may work under tight deadlines given to you by people who do not know the complexity of the problem. You could be working on mission-critical systems and be called at odd hours to fix issues. Programming can also be frustrating. Your code would usually be part of a larger piece of software written by others. Thus, you would be spending time understanding and rewriting code written by others in order to fit in your piece of code. Finally, as a computer programmer, you are usually in the background. If a customer likes what they see, the credit rarely gets to the programmer. Now let us talk about the prospects of being a computer programmer. One can spend their entire career in programming if they choose to. Typically, you start as a junior programmer and with time move into the role of a senior programmer. With years of experience under your belt, you could become a programming architect. An architect's role comes with more authority and responsibility. He or she defines the architecture and technologies of the system, while the programmer is more involved with implementing this architecture. Programmers also branch out into other areas such as project management and business analysis, among other roles. So this brings us to the end of the session. I hope you found it useful. Good luck with your decision.